In this video, I'll show you how to use standard techniques like cuts and transitions to take your video editing skills to the next level. Hi, I'm Andy from TechSmith, where we help you show what you know. In this video, I'll break down the basics of cutting, splitting, and transitioning between clips to give your videos a clean, yet professional look without requiring a professional level of experience. As always, make sure to subscribe to our channel to keep getting helpful video content, and click the bell to be notified as soon as it's available. In this video, we'll be using Camtasia. If you don't already have it, there's a link in the description below to download a free trial. But if you already have other editing software, that's fine. You'll notice a lot of similarities between their user interfaces, and should be able to get the idea no matter what you're using. Now, the first thing you're going to want to do is import the media files that you'll be using into your video. To do this, inside the Media tab in Camtasia, select Import Media. Then just select the video, audio, and image files you'll be using and import them into the bin. Once your footage is imported, it's time to start editing. Go ahead and click and drag the video file from the Media tab down into its own track on the timeline. Now, there are a couple of different clip cutting techniques you can use when editing a video. These techniques are referred to as splitting and trimming. They end up getting the same results, but most video editors have their own personal preferences. Splitting your video clips is when you cut your video into two parts, allowing you to edit each clip independent from one another. Trimming involves cutting out sections from the beginning or end of your video clip. Let's break down each technique individually, starting with splits. You can split your video clip with the button found on the toolbar above the timeline. Just drag the playhead to the exact frame that you'd like to make your cut at and click on the icon. Or if you're like me and you appreciate a good keyboard shortcut, you can also press the S key on Windows or Command T on Mac. There's also a technique known as the ripple split, which allows you to split and move media from all of your tracks at the same time. Just move the playhead to wherever you want to create your split, hold Shift, and drag the playhead to move the split area where you need it. Now onto trimming. Hover your mouse over the edge of the clip until it turns into the trimming icon. Then just click and drag the clip in to the desired length. You can even use the trimming technique after you've already split a clip if you missed a bit on the end. Now that we know how to split and trim our videos, let's talk about transitions. Transitions can be a great way to smooth out any of those jarring or abrupt cuts between two different shots. You can fade, dissolve, wipe, or blur with the variety of transitions we have. Take some time to browse Camtasia's library to help familiarize yourself with all the different options available to you. Once you find a transition you want to use, click and drag it down to the cut between two clips where you'd like to apply it. The clips do have to be touching for this to work, by the way. No gaps. The transition will automatically apply itself to the ends of each clip, acting as a sort of bridge between them. If you want to extend the length of the effect, you can click and drag either end of the transition. With all of this being said, please remember when it comes to transition effects, less is more. While transitions can be an incredibly useful tool when you need to smooth out an abrupt cut between two different shots, using too many in a video can easily become distracting to your viewer, and then they're focusing on the wrong thing. Sometimes it's okay to just leave a cut as is between two clips of the same shot, as long as it's not too jarring to the eye. Pro tip, when you find a favorite transition or any effect in Camtasia, you'll see a star icon in the top right corner. Clicking that star adds the selected effect to your favorites tab, making it easy to find the next time you go looking for it. With just a few simple steps, you've learned how to utilize cuts and transitions to help elevate your video editing skills to the next level. Tell us in the comments below what your favorite transition effect in Camtasia is. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like, and if you haven't already, subscribe to our channel for more great content. Thanks for watching.